Now, let's go over our schedule once again, shall we? Harry, when the maces arrive, you will be...
I'll be in my bedroom, making no sound and pretending that I don't exist.
Too right you will. With any luck, this will be the day I make the biggest deal of my career. And you will not mess it up! Go! Now! Hide!
Harry Potter! It is such an honor it is!
Who are you?
Dobby, sir. Dobby, the house elf.
Here, why don't you sit down, Dobby?
Sit down? Sit down?
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Offend Dobby? Dobby has heard of your greatness, sir. But never has he been asked to sit down by a wizard like an equal.
Well, you can't have met many good wizards then.
No, I have not. That is an awful thing to say. Bad Dobby. Bad Dobby.
Stop! Dobby, stop! Shh! Dobby, please stop!
Dobby had to punish himself, sir. Dobby almost spoke ill of his family, sir.
Your family?
The wizard family Dobby serves, sir. If they ever knew Dobby was here, Dobby will be punished with a hot iron. But Dobby had to come, sir. Dobby has to protect Harry Potter.
Protect me from what?
Harry Potter must not go back to Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry this year. There is a plot to make most terrible things happen.
What terrible things? I have to go back, Dobby. It's the only place I've got friends.
But then Harry Potter leaves Dobby no choice.
Don't go out the door, Dobby. Uncle Vernon said no.
Ah, what a lovely cake. I bet Uncle Vernon won't be too happy to see this cake destroyed.
What's going on at Harry's house? Is that a house elf? Wait a minute. I see Aunt Petunia's cake. Aunt Petunia won't be happy if Dobby destroys her cake. I suspect Dobby will use a levitation spell to move and drop the cake on Mrs. Mason, like the Wingardium Leviosa Professor Flitwick taught us. It's not Leviosa, it's Leviosa. Okay, but the point is, Dobby's gonna want to use a levitation spell to cause havoc. It will be useful to take a look at what Dobby has levitated in the past. Dobby loves food. Plus, he's a house elf and is tasked at cooking food for his masters. How intriguing, Ron. Let's take a look at the types of food that Dobby has levitated in the past. Interesting. It looks like Dobby's wizard family usually eats pizza, cake, and ramen noodles. I love a hot bowl of ramen noodles myself. Mom makes the spicy variety with meatballs. Don't tempt me, Hermione. I've not had breakfast. Okay, let's focus on this dataset then. There are two columns, food type and the weight of food in kilograms. Let's use the table by function from the arsenal package to create a summary table. Then, we can use the summary function to generate a nice and clean table. Great! We can see the mean or average values of the weights in the first row and, in brackets, are the standard deviation values. Great job, Ron! We can visualize the data points using the ggplot2 package in tidyverse. We can use the geomboxplot function in ggplot to generate a boxplot. Looks fantastic, Ron! Ah, you've used the geomjitter function to spread out the points in the boxplot. Indeed, geomjitter is a really cool feature to avoid overplotting. Let's calculate the confidence intervals for the weights of each food type. What's a confidence interval, Hermione? A confidence interval displays the probability that a value will fall between a pair of values around the mean. Oh, so confidence intervals measure the degree of uncertainty or certainty in a sampling method. There can be any number of probability limits, with the most common being 95% or 99% confidence level. These levels correspond to the percentages of the area of a normal distribution curve. For example, a 99% confidence interval covers 99% of the normal curve. That's right, take a look at this normal distribution curve. So 99% confidence interval means that the probability of observing a value outside of the area highlighted in blue is less than 1%. That's right, since a normal distribution curve is symmetrical, half of the area is in the right tail and the other half of the area is in the left tail. Yes, so for a confidence interval with level C, the area in each tail of the curve is equal to 1 minus C divided by 2. For a 99% confidence interval, the area in each tail is equal to 0.01 divided by 2, which is 0.005. Yep, we can use the QT function to calculate the percentiles of the T distribution. The QT function takes in the probability argument to return the percentile associated with the probability. In this case, the probability argument is 0.995, which is 1 minus 0.005. Copy that. In the real world, the standard deviation for the population of interest is not known. In this case, the standard deviation is replaced by the estimated standard deviation. And so, the sample mean follows the t-distribution, which is why we will calculate the confidence interval from a t-distribution. Let's start by calculating the lower bound of the confidence interval by subtracting the margin of error from the mean. We can do that using this formula, which is mean minus QT times standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size. Looking great, Ron. For the upper bound, we can simply replace the minus after the mean with a plus. Yes, Hermione, take a look at the results. The confidence interval for cake weight is 4.87 and 7.15. And the confidence interval for pizza is 6.07 and 8.38. And for ramen noodles, the confidence interval is 4.75 and 7.61. Come back here! Dobby, please, no!
Harry Potter must say he's not going back to school.
I can't. Hogwarts is my home.
Then Dobby must do it, sir, for Harry Potter's own good.
I'm so sorry. It's my nephew. He's very disturbed. Meeting strangers upsets him. Boy, what the devil are you doing? You're never going back to that wretched school. Mark my words.